Okay, so Treshkino is ready. So right now, waiting for Tickle to be confirming that as well. And this should be exactly here. He can be heading into the second game of the quarterfinals between Tickle and Treshkino from Kilt's one-day tournament. One-day 1v1 Smurf and actually Spring there as well. Tournament hosted here. We're having some good fun today. Pretty good game so far. So let's start with the second one from this match. And see who's gonna be potentially advancing. If it's gonna be Tickle from the second game already, as you get in another Frozen Waste Oranos battle right now between the players, and this time it's gonna be apparently one gold spawn here. Okay, and thank you very much for the raid, Big Nasty in there. I hope that everybody who was watching you play here on Wubly is gonna be enjoying some tournament games here as well. It's an interesting one in the Loki macro. Maybe he's just trying to pretend that he's not Brazilian. Or he legitimately isn't. Basically, it can be still anything. Now, there are a few guesses based on the game style that I already have based on that. And basically the gods that have been chosen and everything along those lines. But at any rate, we definitely know that both of these players today and here are going to be quite solid Oranosis all around. So let's see that, how well they're going to be doing in the second game of the match. Now, otherwise, we are only seeing right now front TCs from Tickle. So that's a bit unfortunate. Usually want to be having them slightly spread like that on the left side. We definitely kind of know that he's not entirely all the smartest person on the in the game at this point. No, definitely isn't. Yeah, at this point, this is just basically something that he could be banned from the tournament for. Because it's just obvious obnoxiousness and just trying to annoy your opponent and put him off his game. So yeah, definitely not approving of this nonsense, and nobody should. Now, so all the way into the right flank, you're gonna be having the gold quite nicely protected for right now Trash Cleaner here. Maybe the Turmas will be able to shoot at like citizens from the bottom, but obviously it doesn't need to be surrounded altogether on all around. So of course here, a bit more to the right, it's gonna be having the secondary gold. They're actually fairly interesting spawns as far as the secondary golds, because quite often you could be having like this golds even like a bit close by, but it's a bit more common in team games because the spawns there are a bit trickier. Now it's all the way on the right flank, it's gonna be right now Tickle. Scouting another gold, considering that he's gonna be just naturally forced because of the TCs a bit more to the right, like basically just completely. He definitely will be needing this and hoping there's another one like there maybe, but it would be way too close, I'm thinking. Considering where his gold has spawned, and his gold is definitely a whole lot worse than for Trash Cleaner. So this is, I'm thinking, pretty solid map for Red. Not only because of the opportunity on Radiant this potentially, but all the way to the bottom because of the town center positions, as he's gonna be having an option of not only going for this gold on the right flank, but also the one on the left, which seems to be also not too badly positioned altogether. Really liking it. Really quite liking it altogether. So of course, in the middle, plenty of hunt available. That's gonna be also important to see where exactly the hunt is for both of them. So far it seems that Tickle is gonna be coming a bit more into the right. It's really just his natural spot here. That's where he's gonna be ending anyway, altogether and overall. As for the opponent, he actually, this hunt is a bit further away into the middle of the map. He's gonna be there also for a bit longer. So I'm also wondering where he's gonna be trying to put his military buildings. If both are gonna be at this point going for like some kind of defensive build-up as well, because usually you want to be going for military barracks and counter barracks with one woody and one gold miner. You usually do not want to be stopping your food production so that you can produce of course more mills and villages at the same time. So that's usually why it is done that way, and you don't see Atlanteans basically making military buildings on that far into the middle, even if you for example gonna be having some villages there. As of course, at this stage, we're just gonna be waiting for the first actions to happen. We are at about 3:07. And is there gonna be some kind of difference in the build orders? Right now, there's gonna be temple, one village on foot, one on wood, and two more on foot. I'm kinda liking how Tickle is splitting it. It's not gonna be only one spot, so it's making it even harder for Trash Cleaner to potentially decide correctly where to raid. You can see that's gonna be, of course, the same here situation as far as the gold miner going for the temple. And Promethean coming forward at 3:06, pretty much the same advance time. So at this point, they're gonna be at absolutely the same absolutely the same time into the next age. So therefore, it seems to me that Thresh Greenlaw is not going to be trying what he did in the last game. He's kind of learned that, well, against this type of player, it doesn't have to be working out all that well. And he's obviously at this point on... how is it called in English? Well, at the end of the line, let's say. It's a bit different, but not what I wanted to say, but whatever. It's going to be having the same meaning, obviously, in the end. And, well, Thresh Greenlaw is going to be getting raided here. But not yet. Thresh Greenlaw is right now reacting to in running away. Because he could have been basically just right now scared that Tickle might have gone for the 405 advance. And therefore, he maybe could have thought that let's better be safe than sorry. He's still going to be having a few berries, but they do not have all that many goats. He's having 10. It's not too bad. Quite an early husbandry, definitely approved. As you way too often see Atlanteans going for husbandry when they are having like 2 goats left. I mean, like, what's the point then? Because obviously the second bonus of the high gathering rate, or the gathering rate as far as more capacity for the villages is obviously useless for them. And it's gonna be also good scouting through top by Thresh Greenlaw, also knowing where the opponent is. But he probably hasn't seen exactly the hunt on the left. They're so far nicely protected. And there's gonna be right now the counter barracks and military barracks already done for him. And so far, 2 on gold. 2 on gold seems to be like literally the same. And you can see pretty much like similar situation. Just this time, he didn't exactly make one of the military buildings with the goldie, but rather use the foodie in here. Well, seems to be thinking that he's having enough food for the time being, but we're looking at the amount of goats. For the opponent, he's having about like 6, doesn't even have husbandry yet. So, if he's not gonna be getting husbandry in the next like few minutes, not few minutes, like minute or two, then it's probably not all that much worthwhile. Because he's probably gonna be already eating through them. But it also depends how aggressive his Thresh Greenlaw going to be. Because I'm thinking in the last game, he kinda learned a bit of respect as far as the skill of the opponent, and therefore he might be a bit more campy. As you can see so far, this is exactly what's going on. Right now, having the Turmas all the way to the back. Not sure why. He was probably just looking for extra goats. Not sure, but weird direction slightly. But at any rate, he's gonna wait now switching over, of course, somewhere to the top, going probably here, because that's where he was scouting before. As otherwise, right now the Oracle is gonna be moving here into the ice, so that he's gonna be potentially blocking the gold mine, which is, or rather, which is, would be interestingly positioned here in case there was like a TC there, which it isn't, so therefore, early Tickle will be having to fully rely on the right flank here quite a bit. Okay, so here there's gonna be right now army coming forward. Well, right now fixing something here slightly. As my cable seems to be running down from the microphone, but alright, fixed. He's gonna be fine. And is he gonna be going for the TC or just running away? Seems to be running away. Well, quite a bit early, but obviously he just finished. So that was a bit unlucky timing for Thresh Greenlaw, that he just wasn't able to be there in time. Maybe he could be still finding the one on the left, but it's gonna be only one. So the damage would have been a whole lot important on the right, I guess. Maybe so indeed. So right now Tickle, it's gonna be at the medium Murmilo, and that's a very early upgrade, sorry. Can't see that Thresh Greenlaw doesn't have anything like that, so Tickle is probably feeling fairly comfortable in the game at this stage, since he is already a forward in this early one. They're gonna be trying to disrupt the gold, but otherwise the gold is rather excellent. That's probably not gonna be the proper way for Tickle to be winning this battle. More important could be potentially to try and disrupt some kind of food. But looking at the amount of goats, I'm thinking that actually Tickle is gonna be having a hard time to basically make his advance count. Well, advance as in like advantage. Because he just doesn't have any access to the enemy base. And the enemy just doesn't need to be going out of it all that much. So if right now Thresh Greenlaw is not gonna be messing it up and losing units needless, you can see he's having right now medium Murmilo as well. So both went a bit earlier this time around. 85 pop limit for it, 95 and housed for Tickle. He's realizing that he is housed, so he's gonna be right now at 115 and getting even higher. So you can see a Thresh Greenlaw is here again a bit lower in there. Let's check the economical upgrades with nothing there for him. And for the red player, as he's gonna be slightly disrupted on the goats. There's also some little thought here, especially when you have the base open like this, then you certainly want to be having the goats somewhere at the back where you are a bit better protected. So these are kind of like little small things, but they do matter. Because if he did that, he wouldn't be having to hide all of those villages in the TC and basically have like 5-10 seconds without gathering food there. So all those little things definitely do matter. They definitely do matter quite a bit. Z7 right on pickaxe and the husband that we have seen. And so far nothing else there, so that stronger economy might be definitely working. That is something that in the mirrors can be coming through. But it really depends much more on if the player is gonna be messing up or not. You can see the Kiro Ballista already in. For the opponent, he doesn't seem to be thinking of them. Oh well, he is, but a bit too late at this stage. Now through top, that's gonna be continued trading, but I'm thinking he's gonna have to call us maybe. But so far, because so far it seems like a tickle is gonna be not exactly minding it too much. Seems to be just basically heading straight into the middle of the enemy base and trying to force him to go there. So that's gonna be taking quite a bit of hell of a maneuvering. Because the problem is that if trash clearance or the cleaner is gonna be arriving from the back, chances are he might be notified and noticed. Rather by the Kiro Ballista, and therefore getting more damage than you would be liking. You can see that right now Blue is gonna be falling back, and... is he just cautious because of the Murmillo raiding? Might be. He actually might be at this point. You can see he's gonna be already Hyperion from Tickle. Red is absolutely nowhere near to the advance, so pretty good echo right now by Tickle. Well, the Tickle, sorry. Not a trickle. It's gonna be, of course, quite a massive advantage for him. He's gonna be getting second the armory with second counter barracks and still trying to get into pop limit. And obviously the difference where it's coming from, the hunt. Since Blue was able to gather from the right and left hunt the whole time, whereas Trash Cleaner was basically forced off the hunt in the front, and he was basically right now for the last 5 minutes, even more, he is still inside the base, as he was basically just eating only the berries and the goats in there. That's obviously the difference. And he's gonna be even heading for a second TC first, rather than the Heroic Age. Damn. It's gonna be interesting dynamic here. But I'm thinking that the Hyperion is gonna be quite a bit of an advantage here. Just really depends here again if Tickle manages to screw it up and lose kind of battle and kind of lose an army in kind of bad battle. This is potentially something that could be interesting. Okay, little Prometheans also being Gaia, but they actually seem to be... Oh, they are on stand ground. That's a very interesting mechanism. I haven't seen that before. Look at them. They apparently, as a Gaia, are on stand ground. Huh. Not doing anything at all. Well, if you haven't seen that before, as I probably didn't, then you have just about now noticed what's going to happen there with that. When you're casting Chaos or something that is going to be getting some more Gaia. And they actually seem to be even scared. They even like running away from the fight when they are getting hit. Like, what the hell is going on with that? Or is he right now noticing the villages? Oh, he actually got past his fear. He's gonna be right now getting away with few hits into the villager, but obviously they're getting slaughtered. He just doesn't have enough longevity for all of that. As we are right now looking into the middle and the fight, that's kinda going, of course, better for Trash Queen. There's gonna be a second DC for Tickle for the time being. Let's kind of put some kind of important spot, for example, here. That's an important lady, as I need to be looking into the chat. What the hell is going on in there? So, have a timeout, Akito. And improve your behavior if you don't want to be a perma one. Yeah, so we're gonna be looking right now into the chat. Well, Kilt is my is my mod, but obviously she's right now doing the tournament, so obviously she needs to be right now tackling that a bit more as well. But well, at any rate, we're gonna be right now looking into the battle back here. And as I was saying a bit earlier, that Blue needs to be careful about not losing too many units needlessly there. It almost kind of happened. Seems like that he saved exactly enough for the time being at this point. Now, so on the right flank, there's gonna be some kind of continued trading, but nothing really all that problematic at this point. As you can see, the villages are gonna be way too powerful for all of that. So in the middle, there's gonna be a bit of a costly losses here. So obviously, when we are gonna be seeing more satyrs maybe making an appearance in the battlefield, it's gonna be not all that simple to get rid of them. You can see there's gonna be push forward. Random, kind of slightly random buildings, but they are not entirely random. They are meant to be protecting the gold. So that Blue is gonna be having a bit more presence on the left side of the map. As otherwise on the right, let's check out the villages and the upgrades right now. The baseline in full for Blue. So let's check some kind of small radiant here. It's gonna be the same spot where we can be checking out the economy. And apparently Hendak's missing, so that's kind of like the only difference. Doesn't have to be all that much of a high one so far. But this is looking like a quite an important battle, and considering the fact that his opponent is already having right now the Archai, so therefore the powerhouses of the next age, he gets even having copper shields there, with red probably not having all that many ups, I'll be expecting. Oh, I would be wrong. He's actually having copper weapons and copper mail at this point, so he can be quite solid as far as fighting against the Murmils, and the battle is kinda scrappy, quite a bit. But it seems to me that maybe blue could be winning ever so slightly. Ever so slightly in them. Seems like this is gonna be actually in the end victory for Trash Queeners. So it's gonna be yet again the case of having the replacements there a bit quicker. But nonetheless, I don't think it was entirely tragic battle for Tickle, because of course there were massive losses also for his opponent. At the same time, Trash Queener is right now getting a bit higher on the score, quite a bit. So you're right now gonna be just expecting and waiting for the hero cage from Trash Queener, which so far seems to be at least on the way. You can see on the 2 TCs. I'm just wondering if maybe Tickle is gonna be trying to push somewhere into the Mythic, because it seems that the hero cage advantage is kind of like so-so, really close, and he's basically getting most advantage out of basically stealing the units by the... how's it called? By the extra kills. That's like the most important right now advantage for him in the moment. Well, at any rate, he's right now gonna be looking at another defense. You can see that, of course, the Promethean, only 25% PS damage, is not making him exactly the tank that you could be thinking he might be against the Archai. Absolutely not. Definitely not in there at all. As you're gonna be right now looking into a bit of a maybe counter push, but I think he's gonna be wanting to play a bit more carefully before he's in the Heroic Age himself. As there's gonna be right now Trash Queener with the resources kinda alright, Trickle, or the Tickle. Maybe getting a bit closer to the Mythic Lage, we'll see if he's gonna be able to sneak there. As so far, the villagers in the middle going for the hunt. That's obviously something that Trash Queener cannot exactly get for most of the game so far. As on the left side, there's gonna be a bit of a push forward, but only one villager, but the gold mine. Goldman is definitely important, and he doesn't have any kind of houses next to it. So he's gonna be fairly open, and opportunity. Opportunity at this point for the red player to be maybe abusing him there a bit more. But it seems like so far the Archai are doing quite an excellent job. Obviously, there's a bit of a problem for Trash Queener, since he cannot go fully onto the right gold, as it's continuously kind of guarded and kind of trying to be slightly abused, as he's gonna be losing a few villages here. Certainly not ideal. He does have at least a bit of gold still, so it doesn't have to be too bad. And it almost seems to me that he maybe was aiming for jumping straight into the Mythical Age. Maybe. Now he's gonna be looking, of course, the Turma's direct counter units to all the Archai, so it doesn't have to be all that much of a advantage to be having the Heroic Age units in there. You can see the whole baseline of upgrades already for Trash Queener. Nice place at this point. Yeah, well, would be kind of nice if you are complaining about getting flamed and abused, that if you wouldn't actually doing that exactly in the opposite direction. Yeah, well, another candidate apparently. Maybe you could be just basically banning both of these players at this point. I think it had to be kind of worthwhile, looking at what they have shown so far in the match. So you're gonna be right now expecting, of course, a bit of success rate on the gold. So all the way to the left side. Well, so far this Nymphal Ember seem to be... I'm rather wondering why he actually went through the Hyperion. Because he has been using the Chaos, sure. It did give him some kind of slight advantages, and it's a pretty damn good god power. But he hasn't used a single Satyr. And mythical units are just extremely important against Atlanteans. Even in the mirrors, or maybe even especially in the mirrors. Because once you're gonna be out of Valors, then suddenly you become way too dangerously open to abuse by mythical units. But not many people actually use that properly. It's a bit interesting that way. But there's gonna be Hecate Fortical, and yeah, well, that's gonna be quite a quick one into the middle of the enemy base. And with threat, probably not advancing. Oh, actually, he is as well. He's advancing in the TC on the left side. 66% already in, and he's gonna be getting a 30 TC. So I'm thinking that actually Trash Queener is not looking all that bad at this point. He's looking like that he could be maybe pulling it off, especially look at that huge wall in. He kinda promised, and he's gonna be apparently delivering in there, or at least trying to deliver. Yeah, it's back to the battlefield. I'm not entirely certain though what Trash Queener could be doing against the Tartarian Gate. I mean, like, maybe he can be just casting his own and deleting it immediately. Can he actually still do that? Not right now, sure. But I think that was a time where you could be doing that. Yes, he's gonna bait now the Hecate also for the red player. But he doesn't have any kind of vision anywhere nearby. There's gonna be at least a few villages or a few army. And bit of army. Maybe trying to cast it like there. That's a lot of houses into the middle of the enemy territory. That seems kind of valid. And if he actually casts it like here, then I'm thinking that the spawns could be attacking both of them at once. We'll see. But definitely gonna be still open, as all the way to the bottom side it's gonna be hard for right now Trash Queen to be dealing with that, especially since he is gonna be yet again raided on the gold, but the gold is also running out, so nothing all that important here. Okay, so there we go. It's gonna be right now even the heavy Turma, so therefore heavy Archive might be coming into the game. If he actually opts for them, because obviously the Turmas are working rather excellently to counter just basically the archers, because he doesn't have all that much of an extra army here. You can see the heavy Archive there as well, getting copper weapons at least to improve the archers a bit more. As well, all the way through the top, bit of a maybe continued trading can be still underway, because you can see, for example, the gold mine here is still rather valid. That's gonna be a front TC also attempted to be taken, but the game is still far away from getting completely finished. You can see at the Tartarian gate just basically being ignored by both players, but obviously Trash Cleaner is gonna be suffering for that first. Now the town center is gonna be just about now falling, with two villages also destroyed. Well, maybe could have been actually saving at least a few of them more in there for the time being, but on the left that's gonna be the good trading, exactly as you're talking about that. And all the way to the right, there are gonna be right now enough units actually going forward. You can see the TCs both suffering at least a bit of damage. Nothing all that important really. Nothing all that extremely important, but at least the force of all of the gold here is gonna be rather important. Otherwise the population limit completely screwed, of course, for Trash Cleaner, as he also lost a lot of houses in the middle because of the Tartarian gate. We better be careful about all of it, and it seems that Tickle is gonna be in a much better position to solve somehow the Tartarian gate and deal with the problems that he has kinda yielded all across the map. You can see right now 6 spawns still running around killing more houses. It would be kind of funny if he could be stealing the Hesperi tree and starting to spawn random dryads for the guy. But it would be just way too much at this point there. Way, way too much. But this is actually kind of interesting raiding. 3 citizens destroyed instantly. So right now Trash Cleaner is going to be getting maybe a bit ahead. And he's even leading by 500 points on the score. That's a fairly curious one. Wouldn't have exactly expected that. You can see that the villages on the left probably not going to be coming back, as the one on the right. The ones on the right rather, they could be. And since we are not going to be having all that much of a trade here yet, it might be all about, for example, even this gold mine to the bottom side and the one to the left. And so far, Trash Cleaner is the one who is actually gathering from those. And there's going to be a bit of a sneak forward exactly to deny that a bit more. So well played so far by Trash Cleaner. You can see baseline of upgrades for the Echo, as blue is on the same level. You can see a few Kontari as yeah, well. It's gonna be quite a bit of actually momentum at this point for Trash Cleaner to potentially use, because the gold gathering is a huge problem for blue. I don't think he's gonna be able to really fix it all that quickly. He did get rid of the Tartarian gate at least. You can see that Trash Cleaner is completely not minding at all, just completely ignoring it. Gonna be trying to push through on the two TCs and basically on gold stuff. I mean, like, it can be legitimately working at this point. Definitely could. You can see that the Stimflambers, they are not all that many heroes, but if we can be maybe destroying them, it could be helping a whole lot. Basically just keep it going, but unfortunately it didn't exactly happen. But I'm thinking that maybe like a Palace here would have been a whole lot better, but he doesn't have all that many resources for that. You can see the gold is also rather low for him, but another citizen destroyed for blue. And of course the build up here is gonna be fairly powerful. We don't see all that many extra upgrades, which is not that much of a surprise. But there is a bronze shield for red. Yeah, well, right now the economy is gonna be probably the thing that might be deciding the battles. As he wants to be right now still pushing forward, as on the left there are gonna be, way more villages right now gathering from the gold mine. You can see that red is still checking this out. Still 500 is 500 gold, I mean, like, why not? And all the way to the left, that lone Murmillo, unfortunately, it's not gonna be enough for all of that. But at any rate, it is going to be at least a bit of a notice that maybe Trash Cleaner is well aware that he can be actually moving in that direction. Through bottom flank, there are gonna be actually clean up for Tickle by the spawns, because they already do not have any kind of targets here. They're just getting bored at this point, standing next to the Tartarian gate. But all the way to the top, that's gonna be important battle. Interesting shockwaves by Trash Cleaner, just basically sending everybody flying. That's gonna be right now the Satyr destroyed, and basically the rest of the army as well. The Dryads will be helping, and the Stinfall Embers on top of it. But otherwise, he doesn't have enough army so far at this point for the fight. Seems to me that the economy is maybe slightly healthier for Trash Cleaner, but I'm not entirely positive about it. Can see they're not getting any kind of upgrades. It's gonna be finally at least some kind of Radiant by Tickle. As he's also getting a bit close by on the scores there. Moving forward to potentially deny this, right now scouted by the Murmilo. But otherwise, the upgrade's still not coming forward. And obviously, right now, Red needs to be escaping. He's gonna be probably losing like one villager, but it might be it. But coincidentally, he could be right now sneaking on the gold if he actually notices that. But he probably doesn't know that all the scouting parties that were here have been already annihilated by the spawns. So he can be just easily going there, because he's having a few dryads still available. He has been able right now to push on the gold yet again. You can see the villagers low health on them. It's gonna be making for a bit of an easy raid in. For example, with this Nymphalion, but only 14 hit points. Damn, he's gonna be easy to take down. But special attack into the middle, and it's gonna be golden. Careful, careful. Oh, he's dead. That's a wasted opportunity. Could have been getting special attack into the middle. That could have been probably killing this villager. And maybe dealing some extra damage into the rest, because it's a bit of a splash damage. Now it's all the way into the left flank. Nothing much going on. And right now, Trash did notice that the bottom gold is gonna be open and available. That's actually quite important. And another gold mine to the right side. So let's see if maybe there's gonna be opportunity for Tickle to be getting a few gold mines or the few gold spots here still. Because so far he doesn't make an attempt, and he doesn't even have trade, right? Nope, he's going still hardcore. Still hardcore on this one gold, which is right now running out at only 831. So basically his time is running out at this point for the whole game. And you can see that basically even the TC is not missing. Oh, that's gonna be good trading. Good trading indeed, as Blue did realize what potentially could be going on in here. So important, as we're gonna be checking also to the top, where the Red Army doesn't seem to be having exactly the same success. So congratulations, I'm guessing, to Tickle for winning this little engagement. But yet again, without this gold, and maybe without the chance to switch to the left, the game definitely doesn't have to be over yet. As Red could be still having a few gatherers there, but with losing right now 5 citizens on the right flank, that's gonna be way too much. I was going to say a bit before that actually Trash Cleaner doesn't need to be minding having low population limit on only 2 TCs, because you can see that even Blue is at only 123 population limit out of 145. He doesn't have 45 TC obviously, but on top of that, he just cannot even get the population limit up there. So he doesn't even fight any kind of uphill battle, Trash Cleaner, as far as the population limit. But at any rate, this gold is gonna be gone. I don't think he needs to be really fighting here anymore, there's not much of a point in that. But this gold mine is gonna be another excellent one, and since we have seen that it was discovered just recently by Red, Blue has no idea that that gold mine is there. He could be, if he was counting golds that are supposed to be spawning on a frozen base, so he could be having an idea there should be still one more. But yeah, well, that's probably not something that he did, and he's gonna be having to find it the old school way. Can see a bit of raiding. Still, I think that Blue should be getting at least the 500 in there. But wow, Trash Cleaner is right now going to be already calling it a game. And it's going to be right now then victory for Tickle in the match 2-0. And no, I think he could have been a bit more patient. I don't know. He still did have at least a bit of goals, but obviously this really hurt him. Those 5 citizens there, that was way too massive. Way too massive probably for him. But yeah, well, this gold mine was secure. He didn't know that. He didn't know that Tickle doesn't know. So kinda he just basically assumed that it's going to be some kind of opportunity for him. He didn't really have to be fighting for this gold so much at the end. I think he should have been just basically keeping the army a bit more safer and trying to get some kind of more pop limit, or maybe just trying to go for a bit of raiding himself, maybe trying to take the fight elsewhere. Because once the gold was down to like 500 gold, what's the point fighting that anymore? There's really not much of a reason for that. And he could have been switching into some kind of more of a defense. But at any rate, quite an interesting game. 26 minutes in the end. And it's gonna be victory for Tickle. And therefore, let's head into probably the first semifinals there. Let's check into the post game then at this point. As we are at... You can see the economy is being fairly similar. Not really all that much of an advantage for either side, really just minute. So even through the lost citizens all across, you can see there are gonna be more units killed for the lost, actually killed for Trash Cleaner. So you can see that he was quite a bit more efficient with the units. But nonetheless, the numbers for Tickle, well, that was something that won him. Came in the end. A very interesting fight for the golds here. Going hardcore all the way. Of course, the Tataren Gate's been quite influential. Kind of screwing the red player a whole lot more than Tickle, as Tickle was able to deal with it. But well, at any rate, Trash Queen also lost a lot of houses because of it. And it kind of slightly handicapped him there for a moment. But well, good game. Congratulations to Tickle on advancing into the semifinals. And Trash Cleaner, well, another tournament again. But good performances here. Quite an entertaining Oranos Mirror, quite frankly. GG.